In this video, we will talk about three somewhat similar organelles: lysosomes, peroxisomes, and secretory vesicles. In the video on the endoplasmic reticulum, we saw that proteins are synthesized on the rough endoplasmic reticulum. From there, they go to the Golgi apparatus, where they are further processed and segregated according to their destination. The vesicles that we are going to study today are formed by budding off from this endoplasmic reticulum Golgi apparatus system. So they all are membrane-bound vesicles, and they contain something synthesized in the endoplasmic reticulum. Let's first see lysosomes in more detail. They are formed by breaking off from the Golgi apparatus and then spread throughout the cytoplasm. They are 250 to 750 nanometers in diameter. They contain up to 40 different types of hydrolase enzymes. Hydrolase enzymes basically break molecules down into two or more fragments. For example, proteases hydrolyze proteins into amino acids. Amylases hydrolyze polysaccharides into monosaccharides. And lipases hydrolyze lipids into fatty acids and glycerol. Based on this, you can guess the function of the lysosome. It's a digestive system, or you can also say, the trash incinerator of the cell. It degrades damaged cellular structures, ingested food particles, and unwanted things such as bacteria. Recently, lysosomes are found to be involved in secretory functions as well. Freshly formed lysosomes, which are still waiting for their targets, are called primary lysosomes. Basically, these lysosomes are inactive. Once they fuse with phagosome or endosome and start digesting things, they are called secondary lysosomes. We will study more about the functions of lysosomes in a separate video. For now, let's conclude lysosomes and move to peroxisomes. Peroxisomes are believed to be formed by pinching off from smooth endoplasmic reticulum rather than Golgi apparatus. And instead of hydrolase enzymes, they contain oxidases. For example, catalase. Their main function is beta oxidation of long-chain fatty acids. And another important function is detoxification, which means they oxidize the toxic substances that might otherwise be harmful to the cell. In the body, detoxification is mainly the function of the liver. So liver cells have lots of peroxisomes. So this was about peroxisomes. Now let's see the last organelle, the secretory vesicles. They are formed by breaking off from the Golgi apparatus. They are also called secretory granules. They store the substances that are to be released out of the cell. For example, a function of pancreatic acinar cells is to release digestive enzymes. Once these enzymes are synthesized by the endoplasmic reticulum Golgi apparatus system, they are packed in secretory vesicles. In this, they are stored until needed. When the cell is stimulated for release, the secretory vesicles release them into the pancreatic duct. Obviously, for this reason, they are seen abundantly in the cells involved in secreting proteins. That's it for secretory vesicles. Now let's have a quick summary. Lysosomes, peroxisomes, and secretory vesicles are membrane-bound vesicles. Lysosomes are formed by budding off from the Golgi apparatus. They contain hydrolase enzymes and degrade damaged cell structures, ingested food particles, and unwanted things such as bacteria. Peroxisomes are formed by pinching off from smooth endoplasmic reticulum. They contain oxidase enzymes and are involved in beta oxidation of long-chain fatty acids and in the detoxification of harmful substances. Secretory vesicles are formed from the Golgi apparatus. They store secretory proteins, and when the appropriate signal comes, they release their content extracellularly. That's it for this video. Click here to read the notes on this video at our website. You can also explore our entire animation video library over there. To support us, hit like, leave a nice comment, subscribe, and share the video with all your friends and colleagues. It helps us a lot. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.